So, thanks for coming out tonight. Big bill tonight. We're called Material Objects. And, oh, if you could, be conscious of the walls.
I knew Dom as a person that worked here. Dom mentioned that out of nowhere their bass player was gonna be leaving, and I was like, I think I would enjoy, well, I knew that I would enjoy getting to know Dom in a musical context as an extension of our relationship that we had developed within the record store. And I knew that Trey was a good drummer, and I always loved playing with a good drummer because playing with a bad drummer is fucking torture.
Yeah, so I moved to Ithaca going on 12 years ago and played in a couple bands, played in a couple things, short-lived. Finally, was looking for something like more along the lines of what I really wanted to do and in my wheelhouse. And a mutual friend of Dom and I, as JT, he connected us, and he's like, he's looking for a drummer, you should meet him. I was like, all right, sounds good. And he said, be warned, he's a real asshole. Yes, of course, now that I've gotten to know Dom, it was like the most sarcastic description of Dom that I could hear. The process is pretty simple. I think the way Dom and I have written together since the beginning is it just kind of comes pretty quickly. It becomes harder to put things, it becomes harder to sort of finish things. They come quickly, and then we think about them and mull them over and put two pieces of things together, and we take songs apart and put them together. But the parts and the sounds come pretty easy.
These guys have just been awesome about, you know, letting the reins go loose and letting me get out there and then reel me back in when it's like, now what bar we're in? That was crazy. And I'll be like, all right, I'll do that again.
I'm very fond of music that sounds like a place. It sounds like a group of people. It sounds like a community. That has been a defining force in music or art for centuries. And it's as simple as that.
And do you think you guys capture that Ithaca sound, or as like a piece of it? Do you think you fit in?
I think, hopefully. I mean, one of the things, you know, about making art is you don't know where it's going to fall in place. So, like, you know, mentioning the fact that Dom mentioned that putting out this record is something. We're making this object, and we're putting it out there as an artifact of Ithaca. And yeah, I hope it somehow fits into the sound here.
Any record I've ever been a part of, that's my dream, is that it just ends up in a box in 50, 60, 70 years, and someone's like, what the hell is this? This looks different than all these other ones. I am proud to be in a band that believes in making a physical object, because I think that there's a different relationship to media when you're experiencing it on a tactile level. I feel like a physical object, you know that if you bury it in your backyard, you know, unless they put up some condos, it'll be there in 100 years.
Is that partially where Material Objects comes from?
I think that's a question for Dom really to hone deeper in.
It started in the summer of 2019, roughly. I met Trey first, who drums, and I had, you know, known about him as a person in the community for a little while, but never had met. And, you know, so just the first time we hung out, just talked. We talked a lot about David Berman and Silver Jews and just music we loved. And then we're like, well, let's try it out. Let's get together, it's me and you. And we did, and we just started coming up with stuff like instantly. Like, I didn't come in with anything really prepared, maybe like a few ideas. And suddenly off the hop, stuff was congealing, and that was cool. We were playing together, myself, Trey, and Liam, when Liam was in the band, and obviously we didn't have a name for a while. And at the same time, I was going through a bunch of my dad's business materials. My dad passed away in 2018, So I guess a year or so later, but I was going through a lot of his documents and some of his notebooks and ledgers. Fatefully, a note just like popped out. A note I'd never seen in his handwriting, and it said, "Thought for Dom and others. With a well-placed thought reference to a stone and a sling, David, we too can conquer our Goliath, be it through thought or material object." And he put many examples. I had never seen that before, and it was specifically for me, you know, after his death, you know, it was like one of those moments, like, holy shit. And so simultaneously, I was like, can we name the band Material Objects? And I think Trey and Liam were like, that sounds pretty good. I'm like, can we please name the band Material Objects? And I sent them the note, and they were like, oh yeah, we have to name it that. Well, our EP came out earlier this year, Content vs. Carrier.
You can come buy our actual record at Angry Mom Records, as well as on our Bandcamp, I believe, right? Yeah, we got a shipping department.
We're streaming on all the different places you can stream.
And the new record is coming, and it's awesome so far, from what I've heard, what I've been allowed to hear.
You go to Bandcamp, support all the artists on Bandcamp, buy all the shit. Buy all of it, take it home, enjoy it, give it to your friends. Merry Christmas. It's another run, looking underdone.